The oxygen administration station is another one that seems like it's easy, but it is an important station because it assesses your ability to safely operate oxygen cylinders in the field and administer oxygen via delivery devices to patients. So let's take a look at the oxygen administration skill station for BLS providers. You'll begin, as you always do, with scene safety and BSI, taking or verbalizing body substance isolation precautions. You will assemble the regulator appropriately to the tank, properly lining up the regulator to the oxygen tank, then tightening it and getting a seal, opening the tank valve and checking for leaks once you've assembled and applied the regulator to the tank. You will then check the tank pressure level, making sure it's adequate. At this point, you will attach a non-rebreather mask to apply oxygen to a patient. You will pre-fill the reservoir of the non-rebreather mask, and you will adjust the liter flow to at least 12 liters per minute. You will apply and adjust the mask to the patient's face properly. At this point, you will be advised that the patient is not tolerating a non-rebreather mask, and you have been ordered by medical direction to apply a nasal cannula to the patient. You will get out a nasal cannula, attach it to oxygen, and adjust the liter flow to 6 liters per minute or less. You will apply the nasal cannula properly to the patient, adjusting it appropriately. You will now be advised to discontinue the oxygen therapy. You will carefully remove the nasal cannula from the patient. You will shut off the oxygen regulator and relieve the pressure within the oxygen regulator as appropriate. There are some critical fail points to be aware of in this station. Of course, if you did not take or verbalize body substance isolation precautions, if you did not assemble the tank and regulator without leaks, if you did not pre-fill the reservoir bag on the non-rebreather mask, and if you did not adjust the device to the correct liter flow for the non-rebreather mask. And finally, if you did not readjust the device for the correct liter flow for nasal cannula administration. Also, about assembling the tank and regulator without leaks. It's important to remember that even if you get a leak in the first attempt, go ahead and retighten and reattach the regulator tighter in a more appropriate fashion. It's not the failure to get a leak on the first try. It's a failure to assemble the regulator at all without leaks in a reasonable time frame.